Welcome to Module 2 of the What Works Clearinghouse Group Design Standards Training. This module focuses on the WWC's attrition standard. On the slides, some words are underlined and in bold. Definitions for these terms are in the glossary, which is available on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. To receive a certificate of completion for viewing these training modules, you must view the videos on the WWC website. If you haven't already done so, please view the introduction video before viewing this module. The introduction reviews important background information about this training and describes accompanying resources. You can access all the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. This module introduces the concept of attrition, which is the loss of participants from a research study, and explains how the WWC assesses attrition for randomized control trials, RCTs. The WWC considers attrition an important topic because attrition can change the composition of the research groups and potentially affect the estimated impact of the intervention being tested in the study. After completing this module, you will be able to understand how the WWC defines attrition and why attrition is important. You will also be able to calculate attrition rates, apply the attrition standards to RCTs, and recognize what the WWC does and does not consider to be attrition. Attrition is a key element of the WWC's Group Design Standards Framework. This framework was introduced in the Group Design module, which is Module 1. As illustrated in the framework, once a review determines that a study used a random process to assign units to groups, the WWC then considers the level of sample attrition that occurred in the study.